Hello, welcome to the class of HTML5 programming. So today we will discuss about the CSS3 structural pseudo class selector. So in previous class we have configured the CSS styling. So in CSS styling we configure the background colors of the row by applying the class to every table row to configure the alternating color. So as in this CSS program we have configured this class by the name alter row, and to configure these background color in the program we have used this class with the def. We have declared this class in these rows. So we have declared the class in the rows where we want to apply the background color. So this style of designing table rows with alternating color is known as zebra striping. So in this class we will use another method to apply zebra striping. This is a efficient method. So here we will use CSS3 structural pseudo class selector. So this allow the web developer to select and apply classes to element based upon their position in the program. So for that we have not to use this class or declare this class in the program. For that we have to just write here the selector, that is the tr. We want to apply the background color to the table row, so we have to declare it tr selector, and after that we have to write here colon, and after that this property first of type. So this CSS3 structural pseudo class selector have different values. The first value is first of type. So here with this, as we will save this, and for that we have to remove this class from here. Now save the program. Now let's see how it will be displayed in the browser. For that we have to go to run and launch in Chrome. So you can see it will apply the background color only on the top or the header part of this table. So as you will change here this value, like if you will write here last of type, now save it and refresh the browser. So now it will display the background color at the bottom of this table or the bottom row of this table. So the another value for this is pseudo class is first child. So this is used when we are using the parent or the we are declaring the parent or the child tables. For that here we have to write first child, or we are using the nested tables, for that we have to write this value. So save it and now again refresh it. So it will make the changes. Now it applying this background color to the header part of this table. Again if you will write here last child, then it will apply the background color to this end of this table. So the another value that we will use mostly in this is that we have to write here nth of table, and with this we have to give the end of type. Now here you have to give the value. So here you have to write the nth value. Like here I am writing the third, 3. So now save it and see the changes will occur here. So refresh it. So you can see this color will apply only to the third row of this table. So if you will write here even, and now save it and refresh it. So you can see that here it's applying this background color to the even number of rows, that is the second row and the fourth row. So if you will write here the odd one, and now again save it and refresh the browser. So now it's applying the background color to the odd rows, that is the first row and the third row. So these are the value of this structural pseudo class selector. So we can use this value to apply the background color collectively to the table rows. So this is all about the CSS3 structural pseudo class selector. Thank you.